What's up, everybody? G Mr. Drew. Coming in for a short one tonight. I was going to start maybe an hour ago, but then I realized I need to do some study, so I busted out some of the... I researched some stuff online, and then I also opened up some books. And let me pull up chat. So yeah, I was doing a bunch of studies, studied for about an hour, and then didn't leave me too much time to stream tonight. Maybe I'll push a little bit further, try to get some extra time in, depending on, what I do and how much I do, but I kind of have a clear idea of what I wanted to do, so you may know from past streams, I've been working on environments, and I'm no good with environments, and these are kind of just like, this is just me creating my own world map, blowing the image up to this size, because at the moment, I have like a bunch of sketches that are about this big, and, they're scattered all over the place, so I kind of consolidated them in files on my laptop or on an external hard drive, and now I'm using those as references in order to create all of this, and I'm doing little bits of research here and there, because I don't normally do environments, so I had to figure out these mountains, and how I was going to lay it out, and I really like this look, and I just went back and I looked at all my my previous work and saw that this was actually super accurate to everything that I wanted to do. It's incredibly accurate. Everything from the towns to the layout of these mountains. I love that I got the dragon here. I just had no idea how any of this was all going to come together. I still don't know how I'm going to finish this out. On top of not really doing too much environment stuff. Rendering it is even more so harder. Fortunately, like I said, I wanted to be easy on myself and start with the easiest environment that I had. So, this is all like ice and snow. So, we should be good. Not doing too much rendering, it's not going to be like crazy colors. See, there goes my timer. But yeah, I'm not going to be doing any like time attacks. I'm just hoping to get enough sketches in. Because what I need to do is I need to add something here in this space. And before I add it, I actually need to draw some sketches because I don't have a definitive, basically like a spaceship in this story that I'm working on. So I don't have a definitive one. So that's why I had to do some research on like, how do I want to go about doing this? And I finally figured it out. I decided, okay, this is the route I'm going to take. So I'm just going to do it. And like I said, hopefully get enough sketches out to not have to worry about, like, what is I'm going to do? But yeah, the way that I also want to do this is I've been trying, shying away from showing any of the character artwork and all that. But I might as well just do this because, I mean, obviously I don't know how to legally work. But if I'm publishing these videos are mine and they're dated and they're stamped, and clearly they're videos of me making it. You know, just in case you don't know, I got the old mirror trick here. So it's me for sure. So I'm sitting here drawing these things. Look at me. That's just in case I ever need to talk to chat. So yeah, we're just, let's just get into it, like I said, until I actually have people come in and join. Really don't want to, you know, until I actually have someone to talk to, there's really no reason for me to be talking, right? So, since I don't have anyone to talk to, I'm just going to put my Nerd Soup podcast back on. And, you know, if anybody joins, then I'll figure it out then. But I know how much people aren't watching my videos. I'm working on it. I'm working on trying to make everything better and easier for you. Right now, it's all just rough grassroots, but so yeah, I wonder how I'm going to be coloring and all this stuff. Well, here we go. I got to work on some spaceship stuff. Let me loosen up. See, how's the camera angle? Are we aimed low enough? Yeah. You got me on there. Looks like someone's joined. Hello. Oh yeah, that's what I wanted to look up. Let me pull up some references. Hey, if you're in chat, you're welcome to ask any questions if you want to know what's going on. But yeah, I'm just sketching tonight. What are animals with some tusks? I know, like elephants. What is it, like warthogs? I'm gonna think I might start working on that. Oh wow. Elephant skulls are wild. Me see. Elephant skull. Go. Thank you. So what is this?
Trump, I'm not saying Biden, but say someone comes along, some ridiculously popular person that knows absolutely nothing about government, but they're like, Justin Bieber? He wants to be president? I fucking love that guy. That is not outside of the realm of possibility. All you, if you have some incredible character in that person, and you like them, go with him. Like, but you're literally giving someone the power to run the greatest army the world's ever known. With the most insanely technologically advanced civilization on Earth, and one of the most weapons, you let a person do
shit.
Sirens on television saying
missile incoming to Hawaii. This is not a drill. Take shelter. This is not a drill. And so the response to that was like, this could be an incoming missile to Hawaii from North Korea would literally mean the destruction. Not only of Hawaii, but the aftermath and everything else would have a much, much bigger impact. So that's how people responded. You know, grabbing their little kids and grabbing them and going, where do you take shelter? And going into the bathtub and hunkering down. There was a father in the video, a father who got his like, little 8-year-old daughter and lowered her down a manhole and was like, I think he said something in the video, to survive this. And there are countless other stories I heard from a father who had one child who was in downtown, the other was on the west side of Oahu, which is a good 45-minute drive, and he was physically in the middle. And in those moments, he was sitting there knowing he had minutes to live, trying to decide which child he was going to go and drive to spend those last minutes of life with. The seriousness of this is something that has and continues to be lost on the leaders of our country. And this is one of the main reasons that I ran for president, so that I could do something to make sure that no other American would have apparently went on what on that day. I announced my candidacy for president. We talk about these very serious issues. And on day one, immediately, literally that very day, within minutes, mainstream media started attacking. That's when the whole Russian asset thing began. The seeds were planted to say, oh, she's kind of, you better watch out. The smears started. The building of this caricature of me as something that has nothing to do with who I am, my experience, my background, my abilities, what I'm advocating for. No, the media didn't talk about that. The other candidate didn't want to talk about it. Going on the debate stage. Yeah, man, this is a national stage. We're going to raise these very serious issues about the nuclear threat that our country faces, new Cold War, and what we need to do to walk back away from the regular nuclear casualties. Nobody wants to talk about it. They want to go towards the superficial attacks. They want to go towards the he said versus she said, and ultimately the things that will cause ratings to go up and that will further this popularity contest that they're talking about, which ultimately all of this is the ultimate disservice to voters. Because it takes away their ability to make this informed decision about who should vote for who, what experience they bring, what kind of judgment they would bring, what kind of foresight they bring to this most powerful and important job and responsibility.
Catch new episodes of Joe Rogan Experience for free only on Spotify. Watch back catalog JRE videos on Spotify, including full in the cabinet. It's going to be wonderful. You got it. You nailed it. That was great. And then, well, I mean, there's a lot of really important, serious things that we could and should be talking about. That we should capture. And be able to people provide that pressure for the
my other pencil. There we go.
Cheer him on, and hope he does a fantastic job, and all of you Trump supporters who have brought the puppet of the institution, wish him luck. Bye.
this advisory committee supported it, except for one guy who was like, this is not based on science. Because if you look at the statistics, over 80% of people dying in this country from COVID are people over the age of 65. And like 50% of people being hospitalized over 65. So yes, if you want to save lives, if you want to make it so our ICUs aren't like at max capacity, then give them that primary vaccine based on age instead of occupation.
There is concern though that essential workers are going to be spread as easily as it happened.
I'm glad you mentioned that.
So it's not that cut and dry. These essential workers that are getting it, but these folks have to be at work. So
yeah,
they have to be able to go out and contract when they get the vaccine and then they're protected from the pandemic.
So there's two things there. First is who the CDC designates as an essential worker. I'll get to that in a second. But all of this is built on the assumption that this vaccine will prevent the transmission of the virus, which is what we're hearing from some so-called health experts, we're hearing from some in the media. It's not been scientifically proven. I've gone back and looked at the applications that and then the data that was put forward to the FDA to get approval from Pfizer and Moderna, and these vaccines have been scientifically established to largely prevent serious health complications and death from COVID once you're vaccinated. That has been scientifically established. Nowhere in that science was it scientifically established that these vaccines would prevent the transmission of the virus. And so I see it almost every day, and it's incredibly dangerous where media outlets and some people who are healthcare professionals are propagating this it's a lie, it's not true. But they're basically saying that so dangerous about that is she got the vaccine. If she has then gone and visited with her grandmother, she could still, and Dr. Fauci's talked about this and others, because this virus is lives inside your nasal passage, you can be vaccinated and you can still pass it. And it could have a devastating effect on other people, for example, and who is vulnerable to this. Has not gotten the vaccine. So anyone who is saying that, well, we have to vaccinate these people or those people based on their occupation because we don't want the virus to spread, it has not been scientifically established that the vaccines prevent that. And this is why they're all, Fauci and other guys, they're like, even if you're vaccinated, you have to still wear a mask, you still have to do social distancing because of the potential for that. So I think that's such an important thing for people, especially as people are getting vaccinated, not to have this false sense of security that just because you got the vaccine, now you can go visit grandma in the nursing home because you're not going to expose her potentially or put her at risk. But the second issue is if you actually go off and see on through all the CDC slides that the advisory committee put forward on who is a frontline essential worker and who's an essential worker. Healthcare professionals and first responders, obviously, yes. They are so overworked, they are overtaxed, they should be getting the vaccine right alongside over 65. You start getting past them, and people who are listed as frontline essential workers, working for CDC, you're talking about anybody who works in manufacturing, anybody who works at a grocery store, anybody who works at a, what are some of the other ones, in agriculture. Basically, you're talking about, half of the frontline
Oh shit, that's dope.
So this goes back to the thing that you originally said, is that part of the decision-making process was this kind of justice component. And making decisions based on who gets the vaccine, making decisions about who gets the vaccine first, not based on who's going to be right, or who's going to be ill, but instead based on population. Stuck at home because of the danger, very real danger that you go out and get infected, you could die. The danger of this act about how the vaccine is not effective is to prevent the transmission of the virus. That's not the threat control that every single person that gets it is a real problem because they go home. Or they go under the reduce those numbers, those are the people who should be prioritized to get this limited number of vaccines first, then followed by younger healthy people. To me, and by doing that, you know, really, you could reduce the numbers of COVID-related deaths by about 80%. Reduce the numbers of COVID-related hospitalizations by like 48-49%. That would be massive impact on people's lives and on our country.
But also, in the years that that's not being said enough.
Yeah. I think it's pushing on both our state leadership and the other way, also the Trump administration. So the Trump administration, just in the last few
How are we looking on the stream? Still clean, still focused. Oh my god. Whoops. And then I just punched my mic. Let me see if I can move this.
Oh, I don't. I wish it was. Unfortunately, that's not. Appreciate every day. And an ass like that, this man should put to get high.
And this is one of the editors here. Concern you a bit more than maybe they did when you were younger.
In your city black?
One of the big things that I have is dying in a hotel room by myself. That's about as honest as I can do. And the reason I say that is the pigeon was strike on my swing the 30-second time I don't have it. Two guys in our profession, Don Bryce in Montreal, Richie Ashford in New York City. And I don't think that's the way I want to go.
Sure. I
Sunday night, which now I should know.
So I wanted to ask you, like, you know, because I
Yo, that is wild, man.
Thank you. Sweet man.
Yeah,
they're loved.
Oh,
thanks for coming in, bro.
so dehydrated, and I couldn't eat anything. It was like, I had to chew the chicken, like I was trying to chew chicken soup, and then I would have to drink water to push it down, and I couldn't even get it down. So is it sweaty though? Like, yeah, it's nice weight loss. It is nice. Like, I'm not sexy, yeah, and I'm not saying I'm Tim, so this is what's going on. You know, you live with Tim, you eat like Tim.
Yeah, right.
But for fucking 2 weeks, I was sexy as fuck, sharp jawline. I was back, I was on clonopin, it was nice.
I think it was very
I needed to do a couple clonopins just to get some sleep. I was a little scared. it was scary. It was like I had a newborn, so I think the anxiety was part of it too.
How old did you remember that shit up?
At the time, I was 3 years old.
That newborn.
Newborn. I was quarantining at the History Annual Studio. So it was like.
And then why do you put it on the kid?
So I'm looking at my mother-in-law, where I did then I gave it to Colin Quinn. I was like, I don't want to be the guy who kills Colin
Quinn.
Yeah. So it was rough. Because he was on our podcast. Akash gave it to me. It's the whole thing. Schultz got it. I got it.
Everybody.
Marty Gavin.
That's kind of how it goes. Because, like, well, I think he came from running controller and gave it to me. And then they gave it to Chin.
Yeah.
Wait, so you were fucking the whole thing?
It's weird how it happened. When you get it, I was worn down. I think that's probably why I got so sick. I was sleeping like 12 at night.
Immune
system's down. So I was fat. My wife was pregnant, so like mozzarella sticks was the third craving. So it's just like we ate mozzarella sticks. I was fat. I was at 2:30. I was run down, and then, so it starts out where you feel okay. So the first couple days, you're like, oh, you feel good. And then that second wave of inflammation when your body goes, what the fuck, that's when I got hit. And I had the GI version. There's a GI version where it gets into your GI tract.
That's all right.
And it's fucked.
It's supposed to be worse.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be worse.
It's worse, but you never had a problem. Yeah, I had a headache. It was like a new symptom every day. Back pain, that was
weird. Mine was where it is, like, my headache was here. Just like here, nowhere else, just on the front.
Yeah.
Did you lose taste or smell?
Thank God. If I had lost taste and smell on top of like the not being able to think about food, or it's the only thing that like that would be on top. Yeah. But if I didn't go to the hospital, then I could have been in a coma. I was lucky I just went to the hospital. And the EMT came and they took my numbers, and like, the numbers were okay. And I feel weird. Like, I felt like weak and like, so, like, it's up to you. And then you go there and they're like overwhelmed, so you kind of get treated like a soldier. I would imagine a soldier, that's what a soldier gets treated. They're like, yeah, you check your lungs. Like, I had double pneumonia too. Which is just like, double pneumonia is just a fancy word for like inflammation. But that's what the corona causes, like double pneumonia. But they just kind of like, they take your oxygen, and if you're not low, they kind of just go like, go home and walk it off. And I'm like, I gotta keep.
Yeah.
But you're like, I need someone to be nice. Like, I needed, like, they would be a meeting, and I was like, am I gonna be okay? Like, I really found how much of a bitch I am. I'm a bitch.
This is all I'm a pussy.
Yeah, I am a big pussy, yeah.
Worse
than there's a reason why, like, comedians, it's just not a good thing to catch if you're a comedian. If you're neurotic or anything, you think too much already about yourself, and it was like, all that came out. And I was just like,
I'm not fancy to think.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just a bit scared. And, yeah.
Oh, I'm good.
How did that look? Yeah, that life's amazing, man. I don't trust a kid that I haven't known it that long. But, people are like, oh, you get a love and insulin. I'm like, this kid has done nothing. I just had a conversation with you. I've been on a podcast before. I trust you. I would fucking give you my wallet. And I would be sure that that wallet would be up. I'd fucking trust that fucking baby.
So how old is she now?
She's 3 months.
Yeah.
Sorry, being honest.
True.
I'm supposed to deliver right away.
Yeah. No, the moms have to deliver right away.
The moms do.
Yeah, the moms run away. There's a disconnect. The dad. It's weird.
Like, people are 65 and have cancer. Now, like, that's not the case. You know, listen, that's not the case. It changes every day.
Every fucking day.
So, New York's opening up. Momo came out and was like, listen, man, these lockdowns are terrible. We gotta open up businesses. If we come back, we're open up. We're gonna come back. Like, all right, change your mind. She's in New York. She's the voice of the daughter on Rick and Morty. She was just at a
yeah.
They kill him.
Yes.
It's like, why?
Weird.
What kind of shit are you doing?
Why are you more like, you know, New York's like, New York, you can meet how many Jews. Train in the morning, somebody pushes you, fucking end like Latino movement. Yeah. They're just pulling out, blah, 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 and everyone's dead. But if you live in a fucking country and someone's breaking in your house, you can't rely on the cops. You can't call the cops and be like, hey, man, someone's breaking in. Where's your house? Okay. What you gotta do is, you know, there's a river. And the struggle waiting for you on the riverbank. They get in that. And you know that tree with the eagle on top of it? I mean, you know.
Just hit them off, we'll be there in 50 minutes.
Yeah.
Damn.
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 Yeah. You can get a rifle, you can get like, you can't get concealed. So it's like the laws are kind of strict, but it's like, it's strict here too.
Yeah.
It's strict,
yeah.
But, but I just walked into Dick's and bought a 22.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah. Do you have to wait though? Did they still make you wait a couple days?
Yeah. 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 It's, that's the, it just walk in, and me and my buddy Paul Morrison, one day he just walked in. Everyone watched the news that I got country for buckets.
Yeah.
We just went to Dick. We told the wife we were going to get coffee. We came back with guns. What the fuck are you guys doing? I got guns.
Yeah. We're shooting.
Yeah.
She's cool.
Yeah.
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 She's
like
the
band.
Yeah.
The history of hyenas, buddy. Moving out to the country.
Yeah, trying.
But how do you do the show next?
Do you and what people let us on?
Yeah, so New York's interesting, man, because you have like Schultz out there who's been doing podcasts and all these people. Then a lot of guys just cross their comments. But if they get the fucking podcast, it seems
to be
the same. Yeah. All you get from home.
Yeah.
Like Jim Dillon was like, I'll do a podcast. Turn the mic on.
Yeah.
Just fucking spit pure fire.
Yeah. Yeah, well, we look at you guys. One of us were smart. What's going on here? Like, we're sitting there, like, doing sets for $25. I'm an artist. You know? Are you James Joyce? Or just like, you know, understanding they're in show business. I'm fucking not being true to me. Like, shut the fuck up.
Dude, your lights are on.
Yeah. You're chilling somewhere. Your lights are on. Bro, I want to come over and meet my 6 roommates. I'm 47. It's about me.
Yeah. So how are you guys going to do, especially you, you're going to do that? How do you do it?
What?
Yeah. You're driving in town? What are you going to do?
Yeah.
To get in the city, it's an hour. You're driving an hour?
So I got
every night I got a Tesla.
Ooh, so it's hard to find out.
Yeah.
Cool.
Wow,
that's very high. You know, the internet is nice right now.
Yeah.
I mean, I was supposed to be in a TV show, and I got COVID, and then they still wanted me after the show. And they were like, we want you back to do the show. And I was like, I'm going to get broken. Like,
yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
It's like the Stefano, hey man, come out to LA, come out to LA, baby, want to get on the show. Yeah, let's do it, man. This is months ago. Yeah, I'm just trying to line up, I'm gonna shoot this TV show down there. Oh, who's it with?
Yeah.
True TV. I'm like, are you living in 2000?
Yeah. Are you flying a plane into the past? You're like, man, in 2003? He's like, yeah, man, there's still money in TV. I said, yeah, there's money working at Costco, too. So you gotta go get it. You work at Costco, they should get that money.
That's why so many guys are conditioned. I mean, especially here in LA, like, everyone wants that quote sign and all the way through the brief.
I guess it's because, like, that's been a lot of people.
That
was
good.
It's almost too good to be true. Like, we're sitting here, we're getting crap, we're having a great time. Laughing. I think a lot of people are done. It's like, you know when you're stealing money and like people are getting there just going like,
yeah.
You know, have you seen Brandon Chubb's car?
Yeah.
It's true. I touched it. It's like, it's real. It's real, but it's like,
he's fucking his comic.
Tim Dillon's producer's driving a fucking Tesla.
Yeah. Tim got Tim Dillon with the comics on the room, I guess. They're talking about something, one of the comics out there, and he's kind of shit on me. And he was giving 10 advice to me. I was kind of
where's your museum? I'll be performing on a rooftop. And then you catch me
doing it. We have a studio. So we, as soon as that happens, the studio's in Portland, so my old apartment is turned into a studio. So no.
Yeah, but it's a co-op, so I'm a little, I don't know how long we're going to do it. Because co-op, the co-op board is like, I was super recently like, hey man, I need to check your radio. Somebody heard the business that we like,
I like that.
So, yeah.
So it. Then you come out and you should have once a week?
Mm-hmm. Once a week.
Whoops. Sorry about that.
Wrestling and like, yeah, so I was like, when I first started, this was 2001. So I heard, that's where I started.
New York was pretty.
No, New York was fine, which is good. New York started changing like in the mid 90s.
Okay.
The club that worked out was fucking wild. It was like a night, wild night. It was good that was a story, but something else that happened at the club was like really.
Yeah. It might be a little tough, but I had Mr. Barros, was a great guy. He was doing really, really great. So I would go to the Greek shows. You know what's funny? I started to put them both together in the show, because I would do stand up, and then I would do more research. Right? And nobody cares to me. So I had to do research shows. And kind of hang out the queen. You see the women, dude. They love her. And yeah. She was real. So
when
I'm like, tell me, watch. And then I was there. And I was, oh, shit, that's a bad. Why did women get dressed up for the fucking
When did
show?
You retire, like, here?
I haven't. It's fucking, I'll be in Long Island in 5 years. I'm smoking a cigarette, but all I gotta do is crack my back. Go out there, I give you $5. I'm out of your pocket. I'm retiring that bitch. Okay, now I'm gonna start a new fans only bitch.
Yeah.
I'll live as her. But I mean, you never know. Shit, I've never been living as her.
Yeah. Well, you know.
But I had him, and so then I had a video. He was big in Greece, and then I did this Greek financial crisis video that got real. Financial crisis and financial crisis. Like, it was weird. Because you used to be Greece, like, you know, things that, like, this Thomas, but then that financial video was like a documentary about what Greece was in financial crisis and then club. And then financial guys started hiring me, like, shows. Birthdays,
Corpus Group,
or hedge fund. This is
like, we put less
money. The money was like, it's when I try to explain to my kid what I do, I'm like, can I teach you that? I'm like, bring it more recently. Put it on. Put it on. Daddy makes money. Your daddy's a doctor. Your daddy is bringing a child to see the very son of the day. He calls him up. So, yeah, I remember showing up one guy, he's like $20,000 in cash. And then I did like just hand him another brand, like if he enjoyed it.
And were you going back with like soda and the rest of the thing?
No.
Tell us.
No. All of it. I was all of it. And back then it wasn't that much money, but I was like the first one to make money. And then, yeah, and then I took a TV job. It was stupid. First one, I went to Fusion, a new network called Fusion. They were in Miami. At that time, I was taking Jessica Caruso. I was living with her. She grew up in Brooklyn. So it was called the Brooklyn. I couldn't take it because I was in trouble. At first, I turned it down. We were together, we were married. He was like, I gotta go to the road. That's my career. I was like, I gotta get out of this town. I couldn't see her success. I was so jealous.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I was so.
You were young.
No, I'm old.
Well, I'm just saying at the time.
I was about where
you were more mature.
Much more.
How old?
Those are my 30s. I should have known. She was a Venezuelan journalist, Peabody Woman. I was at the college. So we did like a news show. They were Good Morning America, one on Kelly and Michael. They came on Disney, ABC News, they pushed it. Yeah. I mean, the show, I was there a year, the show got canceled.
Not made well?
It made well. Decently at the time, you know? It made well. But yeah, nothing. And it just set me back.
Yeah, it's not working on
you. And now I'm
getting on the internet.
Yeah, getting fans and shit. It's just like, I'm sitting there getting a paycheck, but nobody's watching.
Well,
I got 13 followers in a year from that show.
Yeah. A lot of comments in LA on that kind of hyper shows.
It's over.
my god.
He's so respectful, people forget, and then he's going to them all through a arena of white people in Wisconsin.
I mean, it's a ton of money.
So here he is, performing his speech.
Yeah, dude, him and I have never met.
All right, man. Well, I've been here for like 2.5 hours or something. One viewer. This is awesome. Well, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Just working on some concepts here. I got to put a ship in here somewhere. And trying to do something. Can we focus? There we go. So yeah. It's tight work, man. This is G Mr. Drew signing off. Y'all take care. See you next time.